listen, she was always full of life, full of encouragement. I told her mom, and this is the honest truth. This isn't against anybody else in the room. She's probably one of the most encouraging girls I've ever, one of the most encouraging human beings I've ever met in my entire life.
I have always said that Tiffiney and I are like two peas in a pod. She is like my mirror image. I don't know how to go on without her, but I'm going to try for my grandchildren.
Her heart was so big and bursting with love, she would do anything to help anyone in need. So kind and caring and compassionate, she was such a free spirit who loved adventure and danced to her own tune.
You know, I don't know if you know this or not, but they say for one negative comment to a person, it takes 11 positive comments to make up for that one negative comment. Tiffiney would give you all 11 at one time.
4 years ago, I met Tiffiney at an MHM playgroup that I dreaded to go. Just Ben Henley would not stop nagging me about coming to these stinking playdates. So I finally went. And it changed my life forever. Because I met Tiffiney. She was my person. And if you know what that means, you know how special she was to me.
She wanted every mom to feel love and support and to have a community to reach out to when they had a need with a child, with a husband, just a question. We have all these anonymous mommy questions that pop up on our Facebook page every day. People that need answers, and they've come to Moms Helping Mom for support. And over 9,000 members, and Tiffiney started this on her own 6 years ago. I know that all of you moms that have shared in this with her are going to become moms to her children. And I'm entrusting them to you to give them the love that Tiffiney had, to shower them with all the fun things that Tiffiney did with them.
Lord, if there's ever been a time that the family needs the same hands that created the universe to hold them, God, is today. God, you're a personal God. You're not a God that just focuses on the masses. God, you focus on the individual. Father, there's a lot of individuals in here that need to be held by you. So Lord, I pray in Jesus' name that you wrap them up, that you hold on to them, that God, you let them know what you knew, that you madly love them. But God, there's people in this room who's never discovered the good news, and God, I ask in Jesus' name that they'll see the beauty of the good news, because it is good.
She is the only person I've ever met who could meet somebody for the first time and have an everlasting impression on them. She always saw the best in people rather than judging them based on the flaws. She didn't pass judgment on anybody. She was full of life and always trying to lift everybody's spirits when they were down.
Ready or not, someday it will all come to an end. There will be no more sunrises, no minutes, hours, or days. All the things you collected, whether treasured or forgotten, will pass to someone else. Your wealth, fame, temporal power, will shrivel to irrelevance. It will not matter what you owned or what you owed, your grudges, your resentments, frustrations, jealousies will finally disappear. So too your hopes, ambitions, plans, and to-do lists will expire. The wins, the losses that once seemed so important will fade away. It won't matter where you came from. It won't matter whether you were beautiful or brilliant. Even your gender, your skin color will be irrelevant. So what will matter? What will matter is not what you bought, but what you built. Not what you got, but what you you gave. What will matter is not your success, but your significance. What will matter is not what you learned, but what you taught. What will matter is every act of integrity, compassion, courage, or sacrifice that enriched, empowered, or encouraged others to emulate your example. What will matter is not your competence, but your character. What will matter is not how many people you knew, but how many will feel the lasting loss when you're gone. What will matter is not your memories, but the memories that live on in those who loved you. What will matter is how long you will be remembered and for what. Living a life that matters doesn't happen by accident. It happens by choice.
And I went to her house and I got to spend the night with her. And when I walked into her bedroom, this is what I knew, she was my first soulmate. Because she had Hanson posters everywhere. They're everywhere. And from that day on, that was our obsession, was Hanson. Thanks to Jason, years later, in our 20s, when we really knew what we were doing, we got to go see Hanson. I can go on and on about Tiffiney. We all can. You know, and I have asked some friends, what are you supposed to say?
I want you to know this is the biggest honor I've ever had, being asked to sing for this celebration. Honestly, this is the greatest honor to sing. And I'm going to try to sing, try to do my best. But you want to know how? You ask how somebody helped 9,000 people? I'm going to tell you how. She had a relationship with God. A close relationship with God. That's how you touch 9,000 people. You let God use you as the vessel, and He flows through you. That's where her joy came from, and that's why she woke up every morning and touched people's lives. Everybody's lives that was touched by her, you were touched by God.
As we roll down.